Hi, this is Rich, and welcome to my blog. Welcome to my new hangout. This is the old days. I got flowers for you guys. I got pretty blue shit, and I got complimentary yellow. It's like all that stuff you learn in fucking art 101. What's the complimentary color for blue? I forget. Oh shit! No, he's got pink on. Is he gay? Which brings up the point, has nothing to do with sharing truth or making money or earning a living, sharing truth, which we're going to get into. But this whole thing about, there seems to be a thing these going around recently here about Obama and gay rights and this sort of thing. Let's talk about that for a minute. I just want to say that... there's this concept, it's called critical thought police, right? The state, I believe, would love to monitor your critical thoughts about the state and anything the fuck else, right? So yeah, that's a bad idea. That's that old movie, 1984, it's like, ooh, Big Brother's watching. It's like, get out of my fucking head, stop reading my fucking emails, stop listening to my goddamn cell phone conversations, you motherfuckers. Governments around the world are gathering this information. They just, it's too easy. It just goes on giant hard drives, man. It just goes, suck up all of our emails. The latest one I heard it about a month ago, that if... Now, I don't know if this is true. This is just bullshit, and welcome to my fucking blog. And this is for entertainment purposes only. Okay? So if you're not entertained so far, go the fuck away. One. Two, don't be doing any comments. What a perfectly fucking waste of my fucking time. I thought I was going to... No! Entertainment purposes only. If you're not entertained, go the way. I wasted your 2 minutes. Bye. But if you're entertained, and you want to hear what else I have to say about gay and lesbian rights... UFOs, ETs, reptilians, GMOs bad for you, swine flu and mercury in your flu shots, hey, stick around. I just might talk about that. Might not, but it's good buzzwords. You can put that in the tag now. Did you know that YouTube, when it loads up your video, they've got the highest top dollar, best money it can buy, word recognition software, and they can basically, this is my belief. Now, if you know more about this, please share in comments. But I'm pretty sure what they're doing is through voice recognition, they're hearing every word you say in every video that we load up. It's all automatic, super simple, no brain required. It's all digital, but they get every word transcribed, or at least the major keywords. Okay, and so it's just one more example of Big Brother watching. But I heard recently that if you don't open an email, like, you know, you got your inbox, right? I use Outlook Express, and Verizon is my internet provider. I heard that if you don't open your email like a week, it sits in your inbox and you don't click on it for about a week or two, then that somehow gives some fucking government, some fucking place, somewhere, I won't name governments, I don't like to point fingers that close and that hard, you know, you understand, but somebody somewhere feels like it gives them the fucking right to snoop your email. Yeah, it's okay. He didn't open it anyway. It's just junk. It's just, we can trash it and we can peek. Anyway, I just heard that. Is it rumor real, true? Feedback. Yeah, what do you think? But what I think is that, yeah, our internet, we're being snooped seriously, and our email can be easily read anytime, they choose. And our cell phone conversations are being totally monitored. I've known this for years and years, and I think it's being recorded. It's like, what's it cost if you got gazillions of freaking dollars to buy more hard drives, to load up more of the audio? And they never need it, you know, but you can globally search, and you can globally search in text keywords that you would like to search for in audio, in cell phone conversations. I think the technology is available and that they can do this, and I think they probably do. Okay. That said, are you still entertained? Really? Well, let's talk about the gay and lesbian thing, the sexual thing. I'm monitoring that. We've got Critical Thought Police. Would love to monitor your critical thoughts.
The motherfuckers!
Yeah. Which motherfuckers are you talking about? And they would love, the big they, would love to monitor this, and probably do. Okay. Now, it's getting past that. They got away with that shit, didn't they? Yeah, they're doing it. So that means they did get away with it. They did that. Oh, goody. Now, let us, if you're the big they, hey, let's monitor and police an individual's feelings, emotions, desires. Let's do that. Well, where do we start? How do we get involved in that? How can we bad guys, how can we get started and take an inch and, you know, an inch and then a fucking mile later? How do we do that? Well, I don't know. Let's start with the whole pro-life, pro-choice thing. We can start with the gay lesbian thing, but let's just get the fuck started. Okay, let's get started. Well, what is this about pro-life, pro-choice? Well, let's pass some fucking laws, motherfucker. Let's pass some fucking laws about what you can do with your body. And above all else, let's monitor your choices. Not just monitor your choices, but police your choices. Not just police your choices, but let's pass legislation that gives government the right to override your freedom of choice about your own body. Let's do that. Hey, that's a good idea. Let's do that. Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. Ooh, good way. Yeah, how? Well, let's do it with religion. Religion, yeah, you know, pro-life, yeah. All life sacred, yeah, yeah. You motherfuckers don't even get what life really is. This is my personal opinion. Pro-life. Okay, let's look at stem cell research. Stem cell research, bad. Young girl doesn't want to have a baby. Oops, pregnant. Oh, let's have an abortion. Let's end this fucking bad idea right at the inception of it. No, that's bad. It says pro-choice. It says pro-life. Oh, it's a life. It's a life. Well, hey, look. This is it's a double standard, I think. I really do. Because you got these other motherfuckers in the labs creating organs. Are these fucking organs alive? They're creating livers and hearts. This is my understanding of what's going on. I haven't really delved deeply into stem cell research and stuff. But yeah, organs are, that's what the latest and greatest is. And yeah, there's two sides. And we argue. But the research continues. You don't see government slamming these research projects. You might hear some news about it, and some congressman is going like this, or some laws trying to be passed about that. But if you step back from it and look at what's going on, stem cell research, stem cells, we are creating live organs. And I'm not right now saying this is good, bad, or indifferent. I'm saying, look at this. This is life. This is pro-fucking life. You can't kill a fucking abortion of a fucking heart experiment gone south because it's fucking life. It's alive. Oh, no, that's okay. That's just stem cell research. That's just a fucked up fucking thing. That was like worse than Dr. Moreau's Island and that weird shit. Which, by the way, they're doing for real, too. Google humanzee as instead of chimpanzee, humanzee. Or what's the other one they use? Humanzee. I can't remember the other fucked up labels they put on this shit. But there is research in places with guards and goons around to keep you from getting in there. But just like Google Jesse Ventura, humanzee. Yeah. Jesse Ventura he's outside the gates of one of these research facilities that allegedly, and for my money, it's way past alleged, they're doing research on cross-breeding the human gene with the chimpanzee or the primate gene to get a goon soldier force going. Now, this is sick shit, but it's been going on. And so now, let's put that right up against this fucking pro-life, pro-choice issue. We're looking at the same basic fundamental considerations. Pro-life, it's the life. We've started this little baby. You can't kill it. It's life at which level? Okay, so, I'm not saying it's simple or easy, and you choose which way you want to go. You want to go pro-life or you want to go pro-choice? Now, I want you to pay attention, though. You get to choose pro-life or pro-choice. The choosing is a fundamental right of a being. You get to choose or not. If you don't, if there's a choice, but you can't take it because there's rules, regulations, laws that say no, then you are having your choices limited by someone else. Now, in a civilization like we have here, you can't walk down the street and shoot people. You can't have free choice in that way. Yeah, sure. But if I was a girl and I got fucking raped by some fucking goon, am I going to want to have that fucking baby? Maybe I do. Maybe I don't. But it's gotta be my choice, is how I believe. If you're into the pro-fucking life thing, no, it's a life. Oh, fuck you. Sorry, that's just the way I'm about it. And if you're a pro-lifer, go fuck yourself. I'm sorry. I'm adamant about my position on that. And yeah, it is complicated. It's not that simple. It's like, oh, pro-life or choice, I'm pro-life. And then in all circumstances, yeah, it's got to be okay. It doesn't work that way. It's not black and white. So every situation has to be considered. And what about it? But the person who's having the baby, I think, should be allowed, without rules or regulations or governments or laws telling them that they can or cannot proceed with this line of evolution, as it were. We've got to be the master of our universe, and we've got to be the master of our own environment and the master of our own bodies. That's what I believe. So yeah, that's that. Hi, how you like it? Are you still entertained, or is this like too gross for you, or too like, oh, please? Okay. So I was going to talk about the gay lesbian thing. Never quite got around to it. And I was going to talk about share truth, make money, which really means, is it possible for people who are into sharing the truth? And I'm not saying everything I just shared was truth. What I just shared was fucking opinion, man. And everybody's got a right to one. So, anyway. Is it possible to earn a living sharing truth? I know that there are a lot of people who earn a good living sharing lies, promoting lies, bullshit, half-truths, propaganda, social engineering, also known as mind control of the populations, stuff like that. Excuse me just a second, I got my fucking uvu saying somebody wants to talk to me. Okay, all fixed. Earn a living sharing truth? Is it possible? I have this, I'm working this little idea in my head about, yeah, you know, it just might be. Might be possible. There are a lot of us who are passionate about sharing the truth or our truth or information about what's really going on planet Earth that we don't hear in the news media or in public education, but is totally documentable, evidentiary, plenty of evidence that proves up the fucking point or the truth of the matter, things that affect civilization, things that affect our planet on a global level. If you step back and look at generation to generation to generation, look at the last 50 to 100, 200 years and into the future, the next 50, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 years, there are some serious things going on planet Earth that is the truth that most of planet Earth people do not know. And they will never know if they rely on public education or the information services, the news media. There are some serious things going on with planet Earth, and planet Earth is in for a wild and crazy ride. And it all depends which way it goes. Is it a fucking total train wreck? Or does it work out really, really wonderful? It depends on, this is my belief, it depends on how many people on planet Earth know the truth about what's really going on. Because we are being brutally fucked by some seriously evil fucking individuals and groups. And it's these individuals and these groups that need to be exposed. The truth of what's going on planet Earth, whether it's war or disease or economic calamity or anything else, it's not, oh, it's just the way it is. It's just life. It's all fucked up. No. No. We are sentient beings here, right now. We have intelligence, some more than others, some less than others, but we are a species, and the divine design of how we are created is that we learn and grow. We get smarter, we learn more, and we evolve and we adapt. Or we change our environment for our survival needs. The idea is that we survive. We figure it out. We work it. We get better. Things get better. Now, the only reason things aren't getting better is because there are other groups of individuals who have a different plan in place for planet Earth. They are very intelligent. They have a lot of money and power. And they are getting better and better. How is that? They are keeping us ignorant and themselves enlightened. They are illuminated. They are enlightened. They understand what's really going on planet Earth. And they are using the truth. Of how things work to play us. And what they know is if they control us in secret and give us lies about why and how things are the way they are for the rest of us, then we won't look for them, find out who they are, we won't find out what they're doing or why they're doing it. And if we don't know who they are, what they are, why they're doing it, then we will not go after them to stop them from making our lives miserable. Because how it works is there's a smaller group of beings on planet Earth who are manipulating and controlling education, finance, health, government, everything. They're manipulating it from here, behind the scenes. They are not the government. They work behind the scenes. They're manipulating. They have their own people or their own group members in governments in all aspects of the human experience in such a way that they can keep the rest of us ignorant and unable to experience free energy, cures for disease, social and economic conditions that are wholesome and helpful and that would allow for a sane civilization to grow in wholesome, healthy, prosperous ways. That is our birthright and that is possible, except that this small group of controllers is manipulating and controlling everything else in ways that keep us ignorant and of the truth. And if we just knew the truth, that would be the first step in understanding who they are and what they are doing to keep the rest of us ignorant and miserable, suppressed, depressed, and unhappy, and not doing well as a planet or a nation or species or civilization. And I believe that sharing truth is one of the most important and honorable things a person can do on planet Earth right now. In other words, help awaken the people of planet Earth. It's got to be the first step. We cannot solve a problem until we understand what the problem is. And we're not aware of the problem. We're not awake to the problem as a species, as a planet. We don't get what the real problem is. And the real problem is like a cancer. It's like a disease. It's like a virus. And it's individuals and groups that are doing everything they can to create wars, to suppress energy technology, to suppress cures for disease globally. They're working real hard to keep us in pain and misery so that they can stay in power. And it's the few controlling and manipulating the masses by keeping us in the dark and in ignorance. And so those of us who, if we can share the truth as we understand it, about what's going on planet Earth, about those controllers, those who are keeping us ignorant, how they're doing it, why they're doing it, and who they are, who the groups are, the groups and families, and dynasties, and the individuals. Because you got to remember, it's about individuals. The individuals, the groups are composed of individuals. And when more of and more of humanity knows who the individual people are. We can focus our attention on how to deal with them. And all of a sudden you have billions of people focusing on a few thousand individuals. And it changes everything in our favor. In the favor of light and love, evolution, prosperity, the works. Ta-da! So anyway, that's what I wanted to say. I said it in under 30 minutes. I thought that was pretty good. So anyway, I've got this kind of idea working about earn a living sharing truth. Because we all have to earn a living. And the way they work is they keep us enslaved economically. We do not have time. Most people do not have time to explore what the truth really is. They don't even know they're being fucked up. They don't even know they're being fucked with, much less have the time to understand how, who's doing it, and what a damn good job they're doing. Okay, so it becomes the job for the rest of us who do have the time or the passion to discover the truth, learn the truth, share the truth, to do that. But look at us. We got to make a fucking living too. So we don't have the time, as much time as we would normally want to put into sharing the truth and getting it out there to the rest of humanity. This is not like a 10-year job. This is like the next 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 years. This sort of thing, this sharing truth that you see all over the place on YouTube and on the internet now, is very important. Hats off to everybody. Some people are making a living. Some people are earning a living sharing truth with their websites and different ways. But a lot of us have a passion for sharing this truth, but don't know how to make a living, don't know how to earn a living doing it. So we have to put our passion, desire to help humanity in this most important way. We have to put it to one side. We'll go out and make fucking money. So I go, ooh, how about make money sharing truth? I go, well, that sounds cheesy and crass. You know, truth should be free. Yeah, I know. So how about earn a living sharing truth? Ooh, that sounds softer and nicer. So yeah, so I've got this idea going. I've got some ideas how I'm going to lay it out and do it. But if you got through 27 minutes of this shit and you're still interested, I'd like your feedback. Okay? Send me a personal message, comment, something on this video. And if you're interested in earning a living sharing truth, I mean the good shit, you know, like who's behind the wars? What causes wars? Why do they cause the wars? Is it the same groups, families? You know, is there some commonality between most of the majors and most significant wars on planet Earth, at least in the last 200 years? Is there? No? Yeah? No? Yeah? Yeah, there is. Suppressing healing technologies? Is there some commonality between those who suppress the healing technologies, you know, for cancer, heart disease, the big killers? Is there cures being discovered for these things, but being suppressed? And are those the same people that are causing the wars? Yeah? There's a commonality behind what is going on planet Earth that is absolutely painful and tragic and evil. And if we, as a civilization, as a planet of sane individuals, discover the truth of who's doing it and why, it becomes a very small group. And they're doing it all. They're doing all the bad shit. It's the same fucking little fucking group, relatively speaking, small group, that's fucking with us all. So, wow, what if we could not just share this truth, but earn a living doing it? Wouldn't that be fucking awesome? So, I don't know if that's possible or not. I think it might be, but I don't know. But I would like your feedback and input on this whole thing. Earn a living, sharing truth, or share truth, make money. It's a cheesy way to say it, but pretty much says it. Anyway, Thanks for listening to my yap. I never really talk about the gay lesbian thing. Basically, let me say this about it. Just like, you know, there are agencies, governments, individuals who control groups, are the spokesperson or the mover and shaker behind any movement or group that is passionately for or passionately against something. And the something here is your right to love and feel emotionally, romantically, and sexually about who you want to feel that way about. So somebody getting on you about gay, lesbian thing, somebody's trying to fucking police your feeling states, your emotions. And it is none of their fucking business, man. It is so fucked up. And I've noticed that a big push in that is, not always, but often religion. And don't get me started on religion. That is a control mechanism on planet the fuck Earth to fuck with us 8 way from fucking Sunday. And they use the religious belief setting morality bullshit as a stage from which to launch their control on planet Earth. And one of the major control buttons is sex, sexuality, and all that stuff. So, yeah, heads up. All right. Hope you enjoyed my lovely blog here. Duh. And your comments are welcome. And I don't know if I'm going to load this thing up or not. I mean, got a little wild and crazy today. But, yeah, thanks for watching. And I'd love to hear your comments and your thoughts about this stuff. Okay? All right.